Hi y'all, it's Jenny with DTF Superstore, and today we're going to be going over a quick guide on how to make patterns in Photoshop. After doing the Minnie Mouse ears and making a pattern fabric for the Tinkerbell ears, it's really sparked a creative journey on how to create patterns to make pattern fabrics in DTF. So today we're going to be going over pattern preview, half drop patterns, polka dots, and plaid. I'm really excited to share this with you guys, and I'm really excited to kick off this entire series with this video. Later down the line, we'll go over different ways to use DTF and pattern fabrics, but today, just the Photoshop tutorial. So without further ado, let's get into it.
First, I'm just gonna give a foundation and show how to use Photoshop and pattern preview to help create your own pattern. I'm gonna create a square for my canvas. I'm choosing to do 6 by 6 inches at 300 DPI because that's what we use for DTF compatible prints as well. And now I'm just gonna use images that I already have saved and place them onto my canvas. So right now I just have some fairies. I'm just gonna place those around the canvas, you know, make them roughly the same size. Add in some bubbles too, just kind of fill out any of that blank space. And I did get all of these images from Adobe stock. Like the bubbles, it was just like a PNG, and so I just exported all of those individually. But everything else was just AI SVG files, and that's what I'm using for this. But obviously you can use whatever you'd like. I'm just gonna add in a couple sparkles as well. Okay, now that I kinda like my little layout, we're gonna go to View, Pattern Preview. This does take a second sometimes to load, and there's your canvas and a repeated pattern view. And as you can see, there is, you know, some empty space that I definitely could just go back in and adjust myself. There is that grid look a little bit, which isn't always a bad thing by any means, but this is just the basic on using pattern preview. If you're happy with how this looks, then you go to Edit, Define Pattern, and then give it a name, and then hit Save. And now, when you create a new project, I'm just gonna choose a different size just so you guys can see what I'm doing. You can find your pattern, you just drag it in, and since you already saved it as a defined pattern, it will be there. Now you can adjust the scale. So the smaller the number, you know, the more repeats in the pattern. You can adjust the angle if you want to put it at a tilt. And so that's just, again, the basics on how to use pattern preview to create your own pattern. So now that we have the basics of using pattern preview, really quick, I just want to show you one of the options that you can use with this tool, is I really like making plaids. This probably won't be like the best plaid in the world, but this is what I use. So I get a shape, select a color, and then lower the opacity. And then just kind of set up your rectangles, you know, just kind of do zigzags all throughout. They don't have to be anywhere too specific. And so the point of lowering the opacity is so that when these do overlap, it does create that plaid look of the darker color where the blocks do overlap. And when it comes to a DTF standpoint, this won't affect your print like other transparent pixels will. This will still read as just a less bright color, but you do get that overlap look that does come with plaid. think I'm gonna go ahead and add in like a little baby blue in there too, a little splash of color. I definitely think you'd be able to make your own gingham prints with this as well. And again, I know this is not the prettiest plaid print in the world. I'm just wanting to give you guys an example of some of the fun things you can do with this pattern preview. And this is just the beginning of all the options that we can create. So now that we have this information on how to use pattern preview, I'm gonna go ahead onto the half drop pattern technique. A half drop is a design that is repeated on the same vertical plane, but when it moves across horizontally, it'll move across and then down half the size of your repeated square. It helps disguise the repeats in pattern and makes it flow just a little bit more. So I have scoured the internet and gone through hours and hours of tutorials and trials, and this method I'm about to show you is by far the fastest and easiest way to do the half drop pattern. So we're gonna begin with a square canvas. I am choosing to do the 6x6 again. You can choose whatever canvas size you would like as long as it's a square. First thing we're gonna do is create a diamond to go inside of the square. So go down to the shape tool, select the rectangle tool, then make sure only the stroke is active. Hold down shift and create a square. We're gonna use the transform tool to hold down shift and rotate the square until it snaps to the diamond shape. Once the diamond is centered, increase the size until it touches all four sides of the canvas. And again, for this project, I'm gonna use images that I already have pre-saved. I got all of these from Adobe Stock as well. And then I'm just gonna bring these into the project and I'm putting the images only inside of the diamond shape. So now I'm gonna go ahead and select all of my assets and put those into a group. I'm just gonna go ahead and name my group as well. So now I'm gonna go ahead and duplicate my group. And then I'm gonna convert this one into a smart object because pattern preview is so large of a thing. If you create smart objects out of it, it's a lot easier to move than an entire group. So creating that into a smart object and then duplicating the diamond shape as well. Now we're gonna go to view, pattern preview, and then select the diamond and the smart object. And you see this empty space right here. So you do see our original group repeated, and then you're just gonna drag the image and the new rectangle over into this blank space and get those diamonds lined up. That's what the diamonds are for, is to help you get it lined up. And then we're gonna go ahead and hide the diamond shape. And there you have it. There's your repeated pattern. That's your half drop pattern. You can definitely see how it's the same on the horizontal plane, but then the vertical is down half the distance. And something I didn't say before is definitely make sure you have your background layer turned off when you define the pattern. And then just for fun, for reference, if I was planning on printing this onto a green fabric, there's just, you know, a little background. Sometimes it can just help out when you're planning to see, you know, how it looks on different colors. So there it is on green. But yeah, there's our entire pattern right there. So turn off that background layer. And then we're gonna go to edit, define pattern. I already have it named because I made this earlier, cute jungle pattern. And then there you have it. There is your repeated pattern. I know it saved a little wonky when I turned off pattern preview, but it is actually saved as the repeating pattern here. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a new canvas size right here. I just chose something large. I chose an 18 by 24 because, you know, that's around the area of a really large t-shirt. And I'm gonna go to window, patterns, and then we're just gonna drag over that tile, and that's how your repeated half drop will look on a different size. And again, you can change your scale to whatever size. Okay, yeah, 1%, it's definitely not the way to go. And then, but as you can see, that's what your repeated pattern will look on a different canvas size. and you'll have it ready for printing. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you guys how to create a polka dot pattern. This was surprisingly more difficult than I thought it would be. Not difficult as in technically it's hard to do. I was just very surprised on how many steps and how it's not just something you can just drag and drop either. So first we're gonna do is get the ellipse tool and we're just gonna make a circle and get that centered. If I can get this centered. If you use Command T or transform, it'll help with snapping to the center. And this is where it's really important to make sure that your ruler is actually set to pixels for this. So go to settings, units and rulers, and change it to pixels. And so since this is a 6x6 canvas again, it's going to be 1800 by 1800 pixels. I'm gonna go ahead and make my ellipse a smart object. So now I've converted that to a smart object, we're gonna go ahead and make 4 copies of this circle. And then once you have 4 copies on the first layer, hit other and then offset. And so since this is 1800 by 1800, half of that's gonna be 900 pixels. So I'm gonna go ahead and set that to 0 just to show you guys what this looks like. So you put 900, see it moves it over 900 to the right, and then 900 vertical, we'll put it in the corner. And you will do the same amount of pixels, just negative and positive, for it to affect what corner this circle is going into. So we're gonna go, other offset. I'm just gonna change that to a negative and it'll put it in the left corner. And we'll just repeat this process with changing the negative or positive so that it does fill out all 4 corners of this. So now I do have it offset evenly into all 4 corners, and then if we just from here you can just hit define pattern. You can just go edit define pattern, but just to show you guys what this looks like completely filled out, that's how we get to our pattern preview. And then from here, there are your polka dots. And then that's how you do a polka dot pattern. And the fun thing about this polka dot pattern is that you can actually use this offset method for any shape. So you can still do this polka dot layout, but use something else. So earlier I did footballs and then just other kinds of sports balls as well. And then something that's really fun to do is once you have all of your circles set and all of them in the proper position, you can actually select all of the circles and hit Command T. And if you increase the size of just this circle here, and recenter that, when you hit Enter, they'll all come back. So that's just one way you can change sizes after you already do this offset method. And like I said, it's really easy to do this with other images as well. So you can use any image you want and just do this. It's also technically a half drop as well, but if you're using all the same image to do a polka dot effect, this is the way to do it. It's really quick and easy once you get the hang of it, and you can just change the size of your polka dots after you've already had your circles or whatever shape you would like to use set. And so there you have it, guys. That's how you make a polka dot.
And there you have it. That's how you can make a couple different patterns using Photoshop. And later down the line in this series, we'll go over how to print, press, and all the different use cases for DTF and pattern fabrics. But until then, thank you for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.